Hello friends, welcome to NIC IT Academy. This is Chandrasekhar. Welcome to the Informatica Power Center tutorial session. In this session, we will see the flat file to table load. Watch the complete session without skipping and subscribe the channel for more updates as well as look at the playlist for all the videos. Happy learning. In our previous session, we have seen how to load the data from a relational database table to a table. So that we have already completed. So if you haven't seen our previous session, so kindly check in our playlist. It will be there. You can practice and then you can practice this current session. So there are different types of data load. So first load, we have seen already the table to table. So we have one table in HR schema that is called employees. Then we have one table we have created in core schema, that T underscore employees. Just we have loaded the data from a table to table here. So now we are going to read the data from a flat file and going to load the data into a target schema. So you assume that our customer, our third party vendor or customer is placing the file in the secured directory. So from the directory, we have to read the data and then we have to load the data into a table. So file to table load. Then next session, we will see a table to flat file load. So current session, we will see this flat file to table load. We will create one file. So you can execute this, whatever the select statement you want to have, just you can execute and export the data. The format will be, you can mention that CSV format. The first option will be CSV. And you have to save this file in a folder. So where I have to save this file? So you have to save this file in this particular source file directory. You can go to C drive, Informatica 10.2.0, server, infoshad, and this is the common path. This is the root path. You can see here we have the backup files, bat files, cache files, lookup files, and session log directories and source file directories. And all these directories will be there in real time. So this C drive will not be there, but from here, server, infoshad, it will be available. You can go to the SRC source file directory. Here we are going to keep the source files. So I'm keeping all this file inside one folder. Then here I'm going to create a file. So just go here and go to the file. You can see I'm going to name it the file as, this is the file name I'm going to have. So click on, so browse it. You can provide this name, click on next and go to the finish. You can see here the file should be created here. So this file we are going to take as source now. So since here we are creating the file, I'm just opening the file. You can see here the data will be there. So everything, the data will be a comma separated file. You can see here. So from this file, I'm going to read the data. So first data I'm going to make as NIC IT Academy. So just I'm making that. Just I want to show you this data is, this particular session is reading the, Informatica is reading the data from this particular file. So this is a source file and the file name is source underscore flat file underscore employees. So from this file, I'm going to read through Informatica and load it into the T underscore employees table. So this table I'm going to load. So go to Informatica now. So we have already seen how to, so what are the different components are there in Informatica. Just you can go here, source analyzer. If already source definition is there, you can right click, you can clear. So don't delete any source or target definition. If you want to delete it, you have to delete. It will be deleted. If you are deleting it, it will be deleted from all the mappings wherever it has been used. So before deleting it, be careful. You can go to the sources. So this time we are going to take the data from a file. So you can give the second option, import from file. So you need to have the, so select the file type as all files, then the file will be available. You can select the file and click on OK. All the information I have given in the descriptions, you can follow the description also. You can go to the, you can check here the file type. The file type is delimited file or fixed width file. So this is the delimited file. So sometimes customer will place a fixed width file also. Each and every column will be a fixed width. So that we will see later point of time. But now we are taking the delimited file. You can mention this delimited file. And if the file contains a header, you can enable this option. So we are informing Informatica that, okay, the first line should be a header. So you can check this option, then Informatica understands first line is a header. Then go to next one. So here you have to provide the delimiters. The delimiter here is comma. So if any other delimiter is there, you can mention this delimiter in the other option. So since here we are using comma delimited file, you can mention the comma. If you look at the difference, if I'm enabling the comma, so automatically the fields are separated. We can go to next. Since we have double quotes in the file, it is automatically taking that text qualifier as double quotes. You would have seen here the double quotes is there, right? So this is a text qualifier. It is automatically taking, Informatica is automatically predicting that double quotes. So it is removing the double quotes here. You can go to next. You can provide all the fields data type. So this is very important step here. The first one, employee ID. You can provide the employee ID is a numeric and it's a 3-digit. If you are thinking in future, the length or precision may vary, then you can provide here. The maximum length and precision you can give here. And first name, it's a text. So if you are thinking in future, it may differ more than 14, then you can provide now itself. Then here, the last name is a text. Email also is a text. And this is a phone number. So this is what we will do, lot of mistakes here. So kindly make a note of it. Since I have two dots, I have to mention this as a text field. If you forget to mention this text field, then session will fail. Then next one is date column. So date column should be very careful you have to give. So this is a date and time. The format you have to note down. So what is the format? DD-MON-YY. So this format we have to give in the properties. I will show you where to give. The next column is job ID. It's a text column can give, and salary is a numeric column. The next one is commission percentage. So that is also numeric only. So you have to provide numeric. And the next one is manager ID also numeric, department ID also numeric. So normally this source definition, this DDL definition will be provided by the client. So we have to get clear the requirement. So what are the maximum length of the column that we have to provide here? So finish it. Then you can see here the source file definition has been created. You can see here the file, the source definition name and the type of this source flat file. The target, since we have already taken this T_employees, I'm not going to import once again. You can go to the mapping. The third step you can follow here. So go to mapping. The third step is creating a mapping. Go to mapping designer, mapping, create a new mapping. M_S_source_flat_file_employees. Just I'm creating a mapping. Can go to the mapping here. Mapping has been created. Just drag and drop your source from the flat file. So can drag and drop the source from here and target from here. Right hand side, you can drag and drop. Source always should be in the left hand side. Target should be here in the right hand side. You can just click on select all. You can connect it. Control S. The mapping should be valid. And if you want to arrange it, you can arrange it here. Arrange all. It will be arranged clearly. Or arrange all iconic. It will be there in iconic. So if you have lot of transformations, you can put easily to understand. You can put iconic. Or you can go for arrange all. So it will be there this way. So before creating a session, it should be valid. So it's as of now, it's valid. You can go here. We forgot to provide the source properties, date and time. Go to the properties here. You can see here, date and time. Just you have to provide DD-MON-YY. So this format, whatever the format, the source data format that you have to give here, apply, okay, save it. Again, it will be updated. You can create the workflow and everything. So go to workflow manager. Create workflow WF_source_flat_file_employees. The naming convention just I'm giving to understand what is this. You can create a session by clicking on the shortcut icon, session icon. So here, look at here. So here you can click on the session icon. You can keep it here. So Informatica will ask which is the mapping you want to associate. Then I'm just selecting this mapping, source flat file. Click on OK. So click on link task and connect it, double click on it, go to mapping, source. Now it's a reader, it's a file reader. So file reader will not have any connections here. So if it's a file, so you'll be having a path. So this is the source file directory. So here it is mentioning like $PM source file directory. So this file is a parameterized now. So this is nothing but this file path is nothing but, so this is the path. So where it will be defined in the Informatica admin console, it will be defined. So you can check here admin console. If you open, so there it will be mentioned like this is equal to this one. So that is why Informatica is understanding that, okay, this path is nothing but this path. And then source file name, you can put the file name. If you want to create any folder and then you want to keep your own file over there, your project file over there, then you can create the folder here. So that folder you have to mention here. For an example, here one is there. If you want to keep the file in one, then you have to put the folder name is one. So here, so that is what the changes you have to do, but I'm not doing it here. Directly I have kept the file in source file directory. Source file name you have to mention, then go to target. The target you can see here, the target table is pointing to source. So this is what we will do, lot of mistake here. Your session is getting failed because of connection error. So you can table or view does not exist, that particular error. You can see whether you have pointing the target table correctly or not. You can go to this particular table. You can point to the target and you can go a little bit down. You can do truncate target table option. It will truncate the existing data and it will load freshly. I'm just starting the workflow. So it will be running here. So I have just started the workflow. It is running. You can see here, get run properties. You can see the source and target statistics. It should read the data from a flat file to table. So this is the flat file and table 107 record has been loaded. So you can go to the target table. You can see here. So this data has been loaded in the table. So this is what you can practice. So kindly practice the session. So in the next session, we will see different concept. Thank you for watching. Kindly practice the session and we will meet in the next session with another topic. Thank you for watching.